young man. Few people have known he rides the wild buffalo, Buffalo Jones. Roaming the prairie,
Kin. They're dead.
Oh no.
It's starting.
This looks pretty good. How long did you make it? What do you mean, how long did I make it? That's it. It's finished.
This is supposed to be a feature-length movie.
Yeah, I thought you had the rest covered.
I haven't done shit.
I paid money for this. Fuck this.
We need substantially more footage than this.
Yeah, let's get the fuck out of here.
Oh, this is bullshit. Let's burn this place to the ground.
So it's been 63 days since I last left my apartment. I'm used to the smell. I hardly even notice it, especially when I'm kicking ass at River City Ransom. That's just part of the lifestyle. Who am I trying to impress anyway? My only contact to the outside world is a bi-monthly anarchist newsletter and many, many threatening credit card bills. They come with letters saying that if I don't pay them, I won't be fit for a decent society of mortgages and rental cars, and I'll walk the earth alone with the mark of Cain on my forehead, known as bad credit. This grotesque form of financial insecurity has caused my girlfriend to leave me.
Loser.
But it has left me with more time for video games. And as long as I still have my fish and a manly aroma, I'll be okay.
It was hunger that became the problem after I ran out of money. But I have survived by hunting the ducks that fly over my building.
I use a modified zapper that shoots 45 caliber bullets.
Someone at the door! My last encounter with an unexpected visitor destroyed half my apartment and cost me one of my lives.
It was on my 23rd day of seclusion when they came for me. I was on the couch in my house shorts playing RC Racer.
It was the Alphabet Men.
But which acronymic government agency did they work for?
CIA? KGB? MI6? IRS? FBI? CSIS? EPA? It was CSIS, the Canadian Special Intelligence Service. A level 3 boss fight ensued.
What?
Final score? Me, 4,562. The man, 0. But they returned later to settle the score.
As I drifted through the void of the afterlife, I thought to myself, Will I be judged for all those humans, aliens, and bionic dinosaurs I killed? Maybe someday, but not today. I still have 2 lives left.
Hey, I figured out how we can finish this movie.
Oh?
Yeah, we can use a bunch of our older shorts, and then we can stuff the rest with filler.
Filler?
Yeah! We can animate extra scenes to fill time. They can be about anything. It doesn't even matter.
It can be like a shitty Fantasia, full of dick jokes.
Yeah!
Oh, that's a great idea. We have to make every minute count.
We have to reuse scenes.
What?
We have to reuse scenes.
It won't be easy, but if we work really hard...
And if we believe in ourselves...
We can make this movie. Hey, you want to eat some itchy bad noodles?
I suppose. Put the flavor packet in now.
What?
Put in the flavor packet.
No, you can't put the flavor packet in now. You'll boil out all the taste.
Hey, what the fuck?
The psychologist Carl Jung had a theory called racial memory. He proposed that past experience of our ancestors is transmitted through our genetic code, which causes our collective unconscious to react to certain stimuli. And that's why I knew, as I stared into this man's cold gray eyes, that his ancestors had plundered and terrorized my ancestors. My heart! My goat! My woman!
Hey, you got a problem, buddy?
No.
Hey, I am gonna fist fuck your face.
I'm out of here.
Want to get some $2 tacos?
Yeah, I guess.
$2 tacos, please.
We should make this a funny movie. People like funny movies.
It's true, they do.
Did you ever finish your epic script for that Fart Doctors movie?
No, all I've got is this promotional poster. It's gonna star John Cusack as a neurotic New Yorker worried about his fart problems. And Willem Dafoe will play his kooky doctor.
Oh, that's not funny.
Yeah, it is. Fart Doctors is funny.
I'll show you funny. Listen to these hilarious scenes that I came up with. Okay, so this guy walks in this room and he sees his girlfriend. And he walks over to her and says, "So where did you go today?"
"I was at the hospital."
"Are you okay? What's wrong?"
"I found out why I've been feeling so sick lately."
"What did they say?"
"It looks like I've been eating for two."
"You're pregnant?"
"No, I have a tapeworm."
That wasn't funny at all.
Okay, how about this one?
"What are you looking at, fish?"
"Nothing." "So, what do those tears on your face mean?"
"They represent all the men I've killed."
"Oh. Well, what about those spider webs on your arms?"
"They show all the time I spent in the joint."
"Oh. What does that brown starfish on your fist mean?"
"You'll find out soon enough."
Okay, stop. These are terrible.
Fine then. Well, what do you think is funny?
Australians.
"When I was a kid, my grandfather always used to tell me the same joke over and over, and it went like this.
How many Australians does it take to screw in a light bulb? 1 million. One Australian to screw in the light bulb.
And 999,999 to burn in the sulfurous pits of hell for all eternity."
Australians.
You get it? Australians.
Do you think that maybe we're not funny?
I guess we're not. Let's just watch Loudon Wainwright.
Hey, wait a minute. What if we do a slip on a banana peel gag, but instead of a banana peel, it's a used condom?
Used to have a red guitar till I smashed it one drunk night. Smashed it in the classic form as Peter Townsend might. Threw it in the fireplace, I left it there a while. Katie started crying when she saw my sorry smile. Red guitar was made of wood, could not take the heat. Red guitar, it caught on fire, and the damage was complete. It burned until all that was left was six pegs and six strings. Kate, she said, you are a fool. You I've done a foolish thing. Placed the remains in the case and I put the case away. Went to New York City for a new guitar the next day. I bought myself a blonde guitar. I had it for 3 days. Some junkie stole my blonde guitar. God works in wondrous ways.
Hello, Stanley. Why do you have tinfoil on your head? Is it because
the government
put radio transceivers in your brain? Well, it's true, Stanley.
The government
did put radio transceivers in your brain.
But luckily for you, Stanley, the government only broadcasts great 80s pop music into your brain!
Ah, making movies is hard.
I know, eh?
Well, you went to film school. Didn't you learn how to make movies?
In film school? No, I didn't learn how to make movies. But I did learn how Martin Scorsese made his first movie.
Really?
As everyone knows, Martin Scorsese grew up in New York City. And one day, while exploring his neighborhood, he came across a boom pole and a microphone that someone had just left lying on a sidewalk. He was pretty hyped, and he used to just take that boom pole and microphone and just wander around town, booming people in the street. He didn't even care who it was. Man, he didn't even have a sound mixer. He would just walk up to people and just boom them for nothing. And one day, as luck would have it, he ended up booming a big-time movie executive. And I guess that executive, well, he liked what he saw.
You got a lot of gusto, kid. Here's my card. Give me a call, we'll set something up.
So he made an appointment, and he called up his friend Robert De Niro. Now, if Scorsese was known around town for having a boom pole, De Niro was known around town for having a sack.
Was it a burlap sack?
Yep. Wait, what?
Was it a burlap sack?
No, not at all. Anyways, the next week, they set up a meeting with a big movie producer at his Hollywood mansion. And when they got there, the producer was just chilling out on a giant pile of money. Scorsese wasn't even worried. He just straight up delivered the pitch.
It's a post-apocalyptic, not too distant future.
Oh, yes!
The president, he's a robot zombie hooker. And there's birds that shoot lasers out of their eyes.
Oh,
and your TV, it watches you.
Yes.
There's a virus that was created in a time paradox that threatens mankind's existence. It's savage.
Oh, yes.
And it's sexy.
Oh, yes. Yes. Yes.
Hey, did we get enough money?
Yes, we have enough. Let us leave.
And with that money, they made a movie. And that movie became known
as taxi driver.
Hey, it's me from the future. I've traveled back in time to save this movie.
What are you talking about?
In the future, we're 1 minute short from completing the film, so I've traveled back in time in this DeLorean to fill time in the past.
Hey, listen to this.
Check out what else I got. Flux capacitor.
Alright, that's about it, I guess. Well, you want to hang out for a bit?
Oh, I wish I could, but I've got important stuff to take care of in the future.
But you're driving a time machine. You could go back to any time you wanted and never be late.
It's complicated future stuff you wouldn't understand. I'll give you a call sometime. See ya.
Hey, you know, you're a real asshole.
You're right, I am.
A familiar form enters the room. It appears that my deranged mind has manifested my sexual frustrations into the form of a penguin calling itself Donkey Punch. I put on some hentai and hope it goes away. But then something off in the distance catches my eye. The Luftwaffe! Sent by my enemies at the collection agency, no doubt. I jump in my P-51 Mustang and engage the krauts. Donkey Punch is waiting for me when I return, which convinces me to finally go out. So I put on my Chuck Norris action pants, my Unabomber hoodie, can't forget my nunchucks, and cyanide pills in case of capture from the enemy. And finally, a magic condom that gives me a +10 defense against fire spells. I am now ready to leave my apartment.
Secrets were revealed to me the day I held aloft my sword and said, "For the honor of Grayskull!"
Oh, that's really interesting. Do you live around here?
I am She-Ra!
We hopped on Spirit and she took me back to the Crystal Palace. Our lovemaking was raw and primitive, like a 4-bit video game.
Finish her.
You're face-fisting my mind!
Hey, we're about halfway through the movie.
Sweet Jesus, I bet everybody could use a break right about now.
Yeah, like an intermission.
Yeah, so that they could go smoke smokes.
Well, what about the other people who don't smoke? What are they going to do?
Well, they could stay in a theater and watch a 3-minute video of us shooting machine guns.
I'd like to watch that.
We need some soothing music to play over the video.
Well, I mixed this fat beat.
Is your blood red like ours? I'm gonna find out.
Oh, that's a fat beat.
Get the item that adds to your personal comfort. Cigarettes, here you are. Get the kind you prefer and enjoy them thoroughly. All the most popular brands.
Yeah.
top quality hamburgers, the most popular snack in the country. We serve them plain or garnished to your taste. Creamery butter, rich, flavorful, satisfying. That's what it takes for the finest buttered popcorn, and that's what we use. See for yourself why there's no showtime treat to equal the crisp, delicious flavor of hot popcorn that's bathed in real melted butter. It's at the concession stand now. Hot dogs, the all-American favorite. Certainly we serve them, piping hot and full of flavor. Call for yours now.
Well, that killed about 4 minutes.
Okay, what's next?
You come back here, baby. So you're cute.
Get out of here, you! Get! I'll hit you! I'll hit you! Get out of here! Ouch! Ah! Get! I'm bigger than you!
I finally reached the top. Feels as though I've been climbing up that mountain forever. Who are you?
I'm God.
Are you going to tell me the secrets of life?
Nope. See ya.
Thank you.
Hey, what's going on?
I'm looking for that art film we made in this box of old VHS cassette tapes.
Oh, look at that. Do-do-do-do. Oh, yeah. Hey, here's a video of Stanley Jumps Love Gap. That's the first cartoon we ever made together.
Throw it in the VCR.
Hey, that doesn't quite look right. Try playing it in reverse.
Yeah, that makes much more sense.
We sure were doing a lot of drugs back then.
Kind of funny how we drew him in skinny jeans with fluorescent green high tops. Who knew that would have been the style 7 years later?
Yeah, we sure were ahead of our time.
Speaking of being ahead of our time, I found that informative documentary you made on the rise of HDTV back in 2003.
Oh yes, we will watch it.
Television. It's been entertaining families around the world for decades. It's brought us classic memories. Memories like the time Arnold Jackson got bit by the dog and was worried that it might have rabies. The time Jack Tripper got stuck in the walk-in freezer at work, and Mr. Furley had to let him out. Or Cheers. Or Night Court. Or Seinfeld and Costanza. Or The Simpsons. Or News Radio. Whatever happened to that show? Yes, it's been a mighty fine ride. Could it ever end? No, never. But it has ended. Recently, movie producers realized that television could and should be changed into a widescreen format, much like the movies they so loved to produce. They called it high-definition television, and it was a new way of transmitting and receiving a broadcast signal. The population was shocked. Presently, 50% of all television markets are receiving digital television signals. The way things are going, this will rapidly encompass virtually all TV markets within the next 2 years. It's only a matter of time.
Wow, that was super informative. I should have followed my dreams and become a documentary filmmaker.
Hey, I found the art film!
Une orange. Monstrosas! Une orange.
Wow, that was beautiful.
We're multimedia geniuses.
Hello, I'm Ted, the magic leprechaun. I live in a giant boot at the Enchanted Meadows Trailer Park. I live there with my wife. She's a witch.
You're late for dinner!
And my son, he's a fairy.
Deal with it, Dad!
But you know me, I can't complain. Up at 6 every morning, walking to work with the other creatures of the forest. 18 years I've been at the Kitten Factory, pays decent, and I get an hour's lunch. I usually go out back, smoke a rainbow with the trolls in the loading dock. I work in quality control, on the assembly line. And let me tell you something. This job isn't all smoking rainbows and petting kittens. Sometimes, there's a bad kitten. That's a bad kitten. Good kitten. Bad kitten. Good kitten. Oh, bad kitten. That's a good kitten. But you know me. I can't complain. I got a pretty good thing going at the Kitten Factory.
See this guy? This guy right here? Whatever you need, this guy's got.
I will give you $43 million for the contents of that folder.
High-risk real estate investment portfolios!
Call my secretary. Now let's laugh heartily and smoke large cigars.
Look at your old man sausage fingers.
Where were you?
I was out.
Out sucking another man's cock?
So what if I was?
I don't know what to do about this.
You can start by shutting your damn mouth.
Where are you going?
To my basement workshop.
That's your solution for everything.
Whoa, whoa, what the hell was that?
What was what?
That last cartoon. That was a worse one yet.
Got the blues, eh? Well, maybe this'll cheer you up. Okay, so a guy knocks on this door. It opens, and he says, "Hi, I'm Brian. Would you like to sponsor me in a circle jerk marathon to raise money for pancreatic cancer?"
Well, that's even more terrible. You would think that as the movie went on, the filler would get better, not worse.
Think about it this way. Out of the 6 billion people on the planet Earth, We're the only two people making a feature-length animated movie ourselves.
What are you talking about? This is you.
Huh? What? What is... Oh no!
Oh yeah? Well, this is you! Huh? Oh. Well, that's not so bad. Oh man, what have we done?
You mean, what have you done?
Okay, we just need to wrangle these guys in before things get out of hand.
It's too late! They've run amok!
Feast on this! Oh my god, ouch!
Ow! How ironic to be killed by their own creations.
Why don't you shut your mouth?
I respawned back in my apartment, but I wasn't alone. I found my arch enemy Hitler going through my stuff. I knew why he was here. My Zelda Gold Edition had often been on his lecherous mind. He was just waiting for me to leave so he could steal it from me like he did Poland. But if he wanted it, he was going to have to play me for it and wager his power glove in a Skate or Die 2 freestyle competition. 100 rounds, one turn each round, one bathroom break, highest score wins. A good gamer knows when it's time for a bathroom break. I take a moment to relax, have a poo, and read my anarchist newsletter. As I pore over the pages, my mind explodes with ideas of leading some kind of revolution against this capitalist corporate system. Sticking it to the man, destroying the machine.
Killing those who oppress me in a maelstrom of violence. From the barrels of my guns, as I lead the revolution of the people against all but the governmental figures and authoritarians.
Then my poo was done. It was a good poo. Solid. Very little blood this time. I then checked the mirror, only to find more hair missing from my head. It appears that the excessive stresses of video games, bloody stools, and bad credit were beginning to take their toll. This troubled me, not for any vain reason, but if I lost my hair, how would I feed the fish?
Left, right, down, up, left, down, left, right, down, up, left, down.
I'm really fast.
I'm a killer slug.
In a dirt hole when you die. Oh,
nothing to
to show nothing to mourn. I'm the greatest gamer ever born. My being is torn between two worlds. My hypocrisy is fantasy meeting reality. Watching TV, it's watching me. Too tired to sleep, too hungry to eat. Too wired, too deep, too horny to fuck. I'm going to skate or die, skate or die.
Skate or die. Skate or die.
I claim my power glove from Hitler and ask him to leave. I have some Mike Tyson's punch out to attend to. But he returned later in a high-powered mech suit. I've never come so close to losing my final life. I think to myself, maybe it's time to leave my apartment, get a new job, a girlfriend, and pay my bills. Because after all, I have only one life left to live. It's now been 63 days since I last left my apartment. I was passed out on the couch after playing Bubble Bobble and feverishly masturbating all afternoon, when there came a knock at the door. It was Stalin, my arch enemy!
You want a party?
No, I wish I could. I was shot in the chest by this arrow earlier today. Well, that's it.
We've used every cartoon we have, and we're still 15 minutes short of a feature-length movie.
I guess we should just give up forever.
Yep, wake up and lose.
Do you think everybody will be disappointed?
Meh.
There's only one honorable way out of this. Seppuku.
Hey, Henry.
Yeah?
I'll see you in hell.
Yeah.
Oh, hold on a second. Let's not kill ourselves. I do have this 15-minute cartoon I've been working on for the last year and a half.
Well, that's great!
Larry. Larry, you have food on your face.
What? Where is it?
To the right.
What?
To the left. To the left.
Please tell me it's gone.
But the food, it's right below your...
No. What? Did I get it?
Larry.
No.
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 It's right... Larry.
Over here? Over there? What?
Larry, it's right to... No, to the right.
Is it there? Is it there?
Larry.
I do, it's gotta be gone. No. What?
To the left, Larry.
No. No.
Larry.
What?
Larry.
What? It's gone, right? Did I get it? Did I get it?
Just let me get it.
I just love when a new science exhibit opens up at the museum. Driver, the science museum is on the left. Let us out in front of it.
Meh.
Hey, thanks again for inviting us here today, Professor.
Don't mention it, Larry. I hope you can write a decent article on the exhibit for the Super Save Grocery Store Weekly Science Review.
I forgot my notepad.
Furthermore, this gives you and Janetta a chance to get to know each other. It's always nice for young couples to try new and interesting things together.
So, Professor, what's the science exhibit about?
Well, Janetta, Dr. Mansfield has made some astounding discoveries involving the atom.
The atom? Haven't scientists already discovered everything there was to discover about the atom?
You would think so. But when it comes to science, new discoveries are always right around the corner.
Oh, look, Larry. There's Hunter Smashington.
Aw, man. Didn't you used to go out with that jerk? Such a jackass.
We went on a few dates. He's a nice guy.
Janetta, it's so nice to see you. You look like a tumble dryer in my pants, set on spin and full of sex.
Hi, Hunter. You remember Larry Melinda? We all took the same journalism class in college last year.
Sure, I remember Larry. How are you? Sweet. I heard you're writing freelance for that grocery store's free science review. What's it called?
The Super Save Grocery Store Weekly Science Review.
And that's an actual publication, huh?
What are you doing here, Hunter?
Yeah, I'm writing an article as well. It's for the World Science Magazine. I've been one of their staff writers for the past few years.
Oh, that's great! Isn't that great, Larry?
Yeah, that's great. Real good for him.
Yeah, it is. But look, I should get in there. Janetta, you remind me of a bowl of honeycomb cereal with fresh, cold milk. I still love you, baby. Give me a call anytime. We'll get together. Take it easy, Murray.
Ugh. I hate running into Janetta's old boyfriends. And it seems to happen everywhere we go. I can't stand the way they look at her. I hate it when they get that smirk on their faces. They've seen her naked, and I haven't, and I know they're picturing it, and...
Okay.
Hey, we should catch up with the professor.
Wow, I haven't been to the museum since I was a little girl.
This is going to be very interesting. There's Dr. Mansfield now. Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming. My name is Dr. Mansfield. Let's get right to business. For years, I've been trying to find a way to create matter out of thin air. Some said it was ridiculous. Others laughed me out of their workplaces, out of their homes. I won't lie. It hurts. Sometimes real bad. Who here knows what it feels like to cry alone in the night? Regardless, their ridicule pushed me. Pushed my research, and today I would like to show you the result of that research. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the Atom Multiplier. By copying the atoms of a certain object, the atom multiplier then uses other available atoms in the air to create an exact replica of the item it copied. For example, as you can see, I have solved all of the world's problems forever. Dr. Mansfield, you're being apeshit crazy.
Ugh, awkward.
Although a scientific breakthrough of amazing proportions, in the wrong hands, your atom multiplier could mean doom to us all. Oh, it's my esteemed colleague, Professor Shelby. Professor, I understand your concern, but rest assured that I have taken every necessary security precaution. How can you be so sure? In today's modern and kooky society,
He's right, Dr. Mansfield. You see, I've been following your research for some time and plan on using your atom multiplier to complete my own evil agenda.
Kitty!
Yes! The atom multiplier may multiply fruit, but it has made me powerful beyond all comprehension. It has given me two supplemental arms. They just burst right out of my shirt.
Oh! Oh my god!
Yeah! Up here, buddy. You like what you see?
He's gone mad with vanity.
Yes!
Hey, stop.
Oh, yes, this is happening. For too long has society been holding me back, but with my new arms, nothing can stop me. I hope that Janetta and Professor Shelby are someplace safe. I can't see them anywhere. What I really need is to find some place to change into my costume. Smashington, you need to stop this before someone gets hurt. The caped spectacle. I knew you wouldn't be able to resist. I'm gonna scissor kick you in the ovaries. You're an easily bruised peach.
Oh, my face.
I didn't realize this was a beat-up-a-loser festival. What's your opinion on this? Well, his forearms have literally made him 1,000 times more powerful. You're cruising for a bruising, mister. Take that! My arms are weapons! I'm going to paralyze you. Your mom never loved you. I'll eat your babies.
Stop it.
Quad punch.
Oh, Charlie horse. Oh, Jesus. God, those hurt.
Eat a pile of this.
Professor, are you all right?
Oh, shit really hit the fan, didn't it?
Professor, you're gonna be okay.
Fuck it, Larry.
How did you know it was me, Professor?
I've always known, but that's not important right now. Listen to me, Larry. You need to stop Hunter Smashington. He's gunning for totally evil results.
But how, Professor? He's, like, really, really powerful.
The atom multiplier. Turn the laser up to full blast and shoot him with it. It's our only hope.
I don't think I can do it.
Focus, Larry. You'll figure it out.
Smashington, it ends here. Smashington!
Back for more, are you, strawberry shortcake?
You may have four arms, but you still got one weakness.
Oh yeah? And what is that?
Getting blasted by a giant fucking laser gun.
Oh my!
We couldn't have done it without you, Cape Spectacle.
Yeah, thanks for coming out, officers.
Oh, hey, Larry. Where did you go?
I was pooing.
Oh, Larry, you missed it. Hunter Smashington went completely crazy, started flying around, and then the caped spectacle came in and he started flying around and fighting and... Oh, God, Larry. Isn't the caped spectacle so dreamy?
She can never know. We'll be right back.
Is that it? Did we make it?
No, we're still 1 minute short of a completed movie. What are we gonna do?
Don't worry, I have a plan.
Oh, does it involve traveling back in time?
Yes, it does.
Oh, that was quick.
I was driving a time machine. I can come back at any time and never be late.
So, what were we like in the past?
Couple of assholes.
Well, I guess that's it then. Yeah.